Okay, so let's continue on with the second stage of weight. Now, between the last video and this one, I did make a couple of adjustments to her height on some of the frames. And also, as I had adjusted her, he had been moved over, or maybe she had been moved over. So I did adjust that. I did that by grabbing the apply all frames, grabbed all of him, and then kind of shifted him over. So you can do that by making a. Actually, I need to nudge him a little bit. I might have moved him a little too far. There we go. And then you just click on to undo it. Now you have to have a selection on to do that. So, but I've not added any new drawings. Adjusted the timing a little bit here and there, but overall, not much in the way of changes. So for this next draft, what I would probably recommend doing is probably adding him, the actual element that she's picking up for the next stage. Wait, did I leave his legs behind? No. Okay. So now, he's there. And just shrinking down that onion skin. There we go. Okay. So she's going down. Probably would help to show her previous frames too. Maybe not the later frames. Okay. So I might go through a draft of just his upper body and then go through and do the legs. There we go. I should probably go up a little higher. Now she is dropping down. He might have a little overlapping action with his head, so I may have to adjust some of these frames. Okay. Okay. And then that's a. I do like that the upper body lingers that long, but this is it's just sort of a weird. Looks like her body stretches out. So I think I'm gonna redraw some of that. Still a broken leg. Maybe not have the knee all the way down yet. Let's see how that looks. Okay, that might look be a little better. How are his arms doing? Up. That arm seems a little hyperextended. Okay. It still looks like a hyperextended arm. Drag the hand. So dragging his head behind a little bit. Okay. I don't know if she's going that fast or he's gonna have that much drag. I feel like she should settle, maybe. Yeah, maybe here. She should settle a little more. So let's do that. Feels a little stiff here at the end. So switch to blue. Let's have her feet be planted. And maybe Okay. So let's see how that looks. See if I have him shrinking like I had her shrink. Hopefully not, but... As she's rising up, she jolts up pretty fast. So I'm thinking in this frame, his head should continue going for overlapping action. Actually, it would probably be an in-between that does that, but let's see. Yeah, never mind. I do want to do that, but maybe not on that frame. Maybe as an in-between. So maybe... Yeah, this should have a swing. Okay, when she's going down, let's bring the head up. Let me bring the head down here. There we go. I bring the head up a little here. Basically trying to make a little more change. This might need to linger in this pose a little longer. One, two, three, four. Okay, so just adding four frames for each. Let's see if that works. Okay, so there we go. Now we've... Well, I mean, he still needs the rest of his legs. Or the rest of his body. Now, I could do his legs. I've been doing them on the same layer. But just in case I muck it up, which is certainly a thing that can happen, might be better for me to start adding his legs in a different layer. Whoops, maybe same color. Okay. Does have another leg. Maybe we should start showing that other. So his body's probably here. So maybe there for the legs. Is that right? I think I'm making his thigh too long. She's also bent. So maybe there. Okay. I'm sure the other foot's probably behind him. Okay, so. Okay, and then let me see if that even works. Okay. Yeah, okay. That seems like it kind of works, alright. It's like, am I breaking this guy's legs? Like, do people do that? So there's well, no. Not quite there. There's his chest, there's his abdomen, there's his hips. And that's probably his foot. And the other leg's probably down. His leg's probably a bit longer than that. He's supposed to be quite a bit taller than her. Okay, so the butt's lifting. Okay. Okay, let's see how that looks. Okay. All right, so she could use some hands. She could use a hand with this. Hi, I'll be here all night. Okay, let's see. Okay, I guess I could make a new layer for just her hands. I don't know if that's necessary, but might as well. Now, where were they before? Okay, they're up on the elbow. Now, where's this one? Okay. Okay. What if she went like, although that looks like that'd break her arm. What if she did something like that? Yeah, that might look good. Okay. Actually, let's maybe bring the elbows up since she's going down and then they can drop. Actually, maybe have them up still. And then in the next frames, what would be the in-betweens, have them come down. If I remember to do that by the time I get to the in-betweens. Oops. I'll keep her hands as they are here. I won't make new hands because she's... If I do, I might end up adjusting her too. We'll see. She kind of lingers in that pose for a while. Which one is it? Yeah, that one. Okay, and so to do that, I'm just left mouse clicking on any of these frames, top or the bottom, hold down shift, select the opposite side. So if I had selected the top, hold down shift, select the bottom, or start with the bottom, hold down shift, select the top, so that they're all selected, plus adds, minus takes away frames. This could probably stand to be shorter too. I think it is longer in the video, but not exactly 100% following the video here. Okay. And there we go. Oh, and because I shortened it, all the exposures here end at different times. Not great, not something we would want. Easy fix. Let's go to the very last frame, click on the top or the bottom, hold down shift, click on the opposite side. So like left mouse clicking on the bottom frame, then hold down shift and click on the top, or click on the top frame, hold down shift and click on the bottom frame, FN at 5, or right mouse click extend exposure. Okay, so that's it for right now. Next section, we're going to start adding some in-betweens, because there's definitely some frames that linger for a bit too long, where the timing is probably okay, maybe. We'll find out. But could definitely use some in-betweens to smooth it out. And as we add in-betweens, we might find that some of the timing might need to be adjusted, so we'll see.